This job I'm currently working on now is a SEW-Eurodrive Movimot, which are normally found in distribution centres that we work with quite closely. Normal faults for these that we tend to find quite commonly is due to the vibration on the drives that they actually sit on. It causes the component legs to snap. So now I'm going to show you how to dismantle the Movimot. There is about 7 screws in it. So we've got one there, one there, one there, one there, and then the 3 here. So as I was saying earlier, common faults we do find due to vibration are snap component legs. So we go over the dry joints also. As you can see straight away, that leg's a lot looser than the previous leg that we did solder. So as you can see from the previous video, the legs on this transformer were snapped. Luckily enough, we did have some in stock, so I replaced it with the new one. And then we would also go over all the dry joints. Obviously, if the solders are a bit too close, we'll be using some flux, which does prevent the solder from traveling from tab to tab. So having put the Movimot back together, I am going to be testing it on our test rig, which you can see here. Here we have an acting pot, which is a potentiometer, which helps us pretty much with the switches to control the actual Movimot itself and control the speed that it runs at. If you look inside here, this is a wiring diagram. This is how we've got to put it all together to ensure it runs safely and correctly. Okay, so what we're going to do is now we are going to apply 24 volts of power to the actual Eurodrive itself. And you should see a amber light there. Once that amber light flickers, we'll then turn on the three-phase bench. And you should hear a noise, that little beep. As soon as that noise sounds, we press the enable, and then we'll go ahead and run it. So if the SEW-Eurodrive Movimot was to fail, was to trip, we do have a plug-in device, which we just plug into here. This device here helps us basically control it from this controller. Basically, it gives us any fault information which was to occur, which would come up on the screen. Going on from there, obviously, we would rectify that issue.